What's up? This is Heed and Succeed, and I want to talk about something real quick. I want to talk about life. I want to talk about knowing when you're going to have a hard life ahead of you, right? Let me stand in front of this light. All right, is that better? So, knowing when you're going to have a hard life ahead of you. So, when you're growing up as a kid, nobody's created equal. So civilization has implanted that system to where we will treat people equally, but nature, you know, in human nature, bullying exists. Bullying exists around kids and adults all throughout the, you know, all across the world. Bullying is a human nature type of thing, you know. Bullying is in human nature. You know, that's a dark thing that people don't want to admit, but it actually is. And there's a reason for it. And the reason is, I believe, is, you know, when you bully somebody, when you go up to somebody that's weaker than you, smaller than you, maybe they have some type of something that is different about them. When you bully them on a primal level, you're basically taken from them. You're basically building yourself up and putting them down, and it elevates you in a primal level. And it's fucked up, but it's, you know, you're taking something from them. You're taking, it's very dark. It's very, you're taking, you're getting something for nothing. You know, you're basically just, you're exercising your dominance over another human being in an immoral way. That's why I don't like bullies. But what I want to say is this. In life, you know you're going to have a hard life of either two ways. You're always getting punked in life. You're always getting your ass kicked. You're always getting shitted on by your family, by the people, your peers. You're always getting destroyed psychologically. Physically, people are exerting dominance over you. You know, that shit pisses me the hell off. That's why I encourage everybody, work out, eat right, train hard, get rest. And if a motherfucker steps to you on some sideways shit, earth that motherfucker. Lay him out. Throw the 1-2 on him. Set him right is what I'm saying. That's just how I am. We do live in a society where it's civilization, but sometimes you have to get, when people are doing uncivilized things, sometimes the solution, you need uncivilized solutions. But here's what I'm saying though. Back to what I was saying. In life, you know you're going to have a hard life if you're a pretty girl, right? Beautiful women out there, right? They're everywhere. We see them. Beautiful, pretty, sexy things, man. Girls that you just look, they got porcelain skin. They're looking so nice. You know what I mean? They just got that body. They just exude that sexuality, that femininity, you know? And it can't be denied. You can't deny that beauty. You can't deny it, right? It's a fact. But what I want to say is, this is an example of a person, of a human being, of a Homo sapien. They're going to have an easy life because they're going to get something for nothing. Them just existing, they're going to get something. Why do you think all these women are running around here wearing athletic pants? Why are they wearing makeup? Why do they spend $200 to get their hair done? Why are they wearing the perfect shirt that shows, that picks up their, you know, their breasts and shows them in a perfect way? They're gonna get something for nothing is what I'm saying. Why do they go up to you and act all cute and nice and feminine? Because they want to get something for nothing. They want you to do something for them. Not saying anything's wrong about this, I'm just stating it out. Girls learn at an early age that they could use their cuteness to manipulate and get what they want out of guys. Not saying it's good or wrong, I'm just saying that that's just what it is. This is just facts, this is nature. So this is what I'm saying. This is an example of somebody who's going to have easy life. They're going to get something for nothing. You have a lot of women running around here. You have a lot of women out here. You know what I'm saying? They got a baby daddy that provides for them. But they also are running around here partying still, even though they have children. They have kids. They're still dressing like they're single and they don't have no kids. But, you know, they're out here. Let me just say this. They have a baby daddy who takes care of them, pays their bills, all that stuff. They live with them. But then they're still having all these side dudes. And this is a lot of women, by the way. Now, this is an example of somebody who's gonna have it easy in life. There's options, bro. This is abundance. Whereas, if you're a guy and you don't get a lot of play from women, you don't get a lot of acceptance from the opposite sex. You have a lot of rejection coming your way from females. And that rejection, some guys don't read it very well because women can be passive. Most of the rejection that I've had in my life when it comes to women has been passive, right? It hasn't been outward, direct rejection. It's always been passive, a little, you know, they take little sideways jabs at you, little shots at you from a distance. Now, what I'm saying is this. That's an example of me. I'm not getting something for nothing. I can't just go up to a woman and have her liking me and have her wanting me. And I'm realizing this. I'm realizing, you know, and it's a realization that a lot of guys don't want to admit. They want to go on YouTube. They want to subscribe to all these dating channels and they want to say, well, it's about confidence. It's about this. Nah, man, I've seen some of the most insecure dudes. I've seen some of the most frail-looking, insecure, goofy-looking motherfuckers with beautiful women, and it has to do with looks. It's because the women find them attractive. This is just a fact. The women found whatever features they had attractive. I've been in front of a woman, in front of a girl who, it was a guy, it was a Mexican guy with green eyes. The girl literally told him, You have the most beautiful eyes, to his face. She was just engrossed in his appearance, and she was just marveling at him, admiring him, and she outright let him know, "You have beautiful eyes." Now, that guy, he doesn't have any confidence issues because all his life, he's had that positive reinforcement from the opposite sex. So it's not going to be a surprise when you see a new girl by his side every damn weekend. Whereas if you're a guy like me, you don't get that positive reinforcement. In fact, you get negative reinforcement. And I've already talked about this, so I don't want to really elaborate on it. But yeah, you're getting negative reinforcement. So no, guys like me, we aren't going to get something for nothing. In fact, we might not even get something for something. We might get nothing for something. Okay? We can invest in our appearance. We can invest in haircuts. We can invest in cars and houses. We can invest in dating coaches. We can invest in all these resources. We can invest in trying to learn, like I said, develop social skills. We can invest in all these things. All this crap we can invest in. And then in the end of the day, when the smoke settles, the dust clears, when midnight strikes and you're laying down, there's a guy out there in a dirty ass tank top who hasn't taken a shower in 3 days, wearing some dusty ass shoes, and he's pulling some of the hottest bitches you've ever seen in your life. Some of the baddest chicks you've ever seen in your life. And this guy's wearing, you know what I mean? No haircut. Looking like an extra from a, you know, from Home Alone. Just looking terrible, right? Looking tore up. But he's pulling these bad chicks. Whereas you're fly. You do all the things you know You know what I mean? All these things, you research, you wear these colognes and shit, and you still not getting no ass. What I wanted to say was this, just to wrap this up. In life, life ain't fair, you guys. Life isn't fair. Some people will have to work all their life and they ain't gonna get shit. Some people don't have to do anything and they're gonna get everything. Some people will have to work and receive at maybe at somewhat of an even rate. For example, you might have two girls, sisters. One of them is pretty. One of them is a plain Jane. The pretty one gets all the attention. All the male attention. When she's growing up, guys are going to be taking her home, giving her rides home, taking her out on dates, taking her out to concerts, taking her out to dinners, buying her gifts. She's always going to have a Valentine's. Whereas the plain Jane, she's going to be alone. She's going to have a lot of time. She's going to be very self-conscious because she's going to discern the differences of how people treat her based on their appearances. So I just want to let people know. It's a rigged game out here. It's rigged. Don't beat yourself up because it's not your fault. It's not your fault, you guys. Right? Whatever your situation is, the loneliness, the rejection, the BS, the pain, the emotional pain, all that crap. I just want to let you guys know it's not your fault. Don't lose sleep over it. Because it's not your damn fault. This is a rigged game we're talking about here. So that's all I wanted to say. Keep your heart up. Keep your head up. Keep your heart strong. You know, don't get beaten up emotionally over this. And mentally. Don't get beaten up. You know what I mean? Peace out. Take care. Like I said before. Some people, they get something for nothing. Other people, they get something for something. Then if you're like, you know, some people, and it usually comes down to being very unattractive, these people get nothing. They get nothing for something. Deuces.